You'll be leaving us tomorrow, Kennedy.
Oh.
You'll be going back to the United States. We've just received your extradition order.
Good old Uncle Sam.
As agreed by both parties, Margaret May Kennedy will be returned to the United States of America and placed in a state penitentiary where she will serve the full sentence as handed down by the Australian courts. No deals, Kennedy. Just a change of scenery.
Your name is Carol Coulson? Is that correct?
Yes.
And you've been charged with murder and assault with a weapon. And you've been remanded in custody awaiting trial. Is that correct?
Oh, please, Miss Ferguson.
Is that correct?
Yes.
You're the librarian at the East Bank Library, aren't you? Now, I was there the day the debt collector came to see you.
You've been in this place too long, you know that? I mean, me, a librarian? I've read two books in my life, Screw, and both of them were porn with pictures. I mean, me, a librarian? I thought you knew how to get booze into this joint.
Yeah, so what?
How about it? I haven't seen none yet.
Well, I was going to get me mate Roxy to bring some in, only I don't know where she is at the moment.
God, you whackers are flaming useless. Get me own stuff in. I'll get this joint jumping somehow. I'll have a bloke, you might as well have a drink. What do you say, old timer?
Oh, you old rotten little tart. Flaming useless. I don't know how I'm going to get this lot finished.
Yeah, at least she's not playing funny buggers this arvo. I thought I was sharing with Mary Poppins this morning.
Yeah, kiss me. Creeps, all this chopping and changing like a flaming yo-yo. Oh, whatever happened? I thought you were never coming back.
Yeah, you're being shipped back to the old US of A, or are we stuck with you here?
Oh, yeah. They're shipping me back.
Congratulations.
Well, how come you look like you got death row or something?
Yeah, I thought that's what you wanted.
Of course it is, you conniving old bitch. The long face is for our benefit. You can forget it. You're getting off scot-free, and we helped you do it.
I'm not getting off.
Yeah, of course you are. You're the press on your side, haven't you? What do you reckon the next step is, ladies? Reporters lined up to meet the plane? You make me sick.
It's not going to be like that. Oh, yeah. I'm going home. And I might as well be stuck here.
What do you mean?
When I get back, I've got to serve my whole sentence.
Nah, don't give me that. The parole, you're like a shot.
Oh, you don't understand. There's not going to be any parole. Douglas just told me it's part of a deal they made with the states.
Well, 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 my heart bleeds for you. At least you won't be lousing up any more kids' lives.
I didn't want to louse up anyone's life. All I wanted was the bright lights and bit of fun for myself. Well, that's not too much of no bugger to ask, is it? Now, all I've got is 20 years in the pen. I'll never really see the States again.
Well, at least you'll be able to see your grandchildren, love.
Oh, no way. My son-in-law isn't going to let them kids near jail. He can't afford it in his line of business. All I've got to look forward to is a joint worse than this. You got what you wanted, B. I'm not gonna get out until I kick the bucket.
I'm going home. Did Judy tell you?
Yeah, she did.
Look, I'm sorry about what happened yesterday. That we quarrelled, I mean.
Why the hell are you going home? Because Manoli told you to?
No, because we sorted things out. He understands the way I feel.
I don't believe it. Look, don't you see? All he wants you to do is to go home. Then it'll all be exactly the same.
No, it won't. Not this time.
Of course it will, Litsa. Your father won't change.
Maybe not, but at least he'll listen to me. We'll talk to him together.
If you go back there, you'll never be free. You had a chance here. Don't you realise that yet?
I realise that you can have too much freedom. How can you be free when you can't even talk to the people you love?
Oh, for God's sake.
Manoli and I are getting married. We respect each other and we'll work out our problems together.
Yeah, all happy families together, huh?
Mickey, we've all got problems. But you just can't run away from them, pretend they don't exist. I know that now. Your father offered me some good advice. He told me to talk to Manoli. He was right. Maybe you should do the same with Cliff.
Cliff and I are fine. We already understand each other. Why don't you forget it?
Okay. I don't want to fight with you, Mickey. I'd rather we were friends.
Hi. You ready to go, Lisa?
We're going to drop in on our folks just to let them know we're not two-headed monsters after all. You'll be all right to hold the fort on your own?
Of course I will. That's what I'm here for, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. Well, let's get this show on the road, huh?
Mickey, I want to thank you. You have helped me sort out what I wanted, even if we don't agree on everything.
Yeah, well, guess we're all different, huh? Well, you know where we are if you need us.
Well, Joan, how are you feeling after what happened yesterday?
Oh, fine, thanks.
Good. Now, I know it's not very easy for you having Coulson here.
It doesn't bother me, really.
Are you sure? Thorwyn did threaten you.
Yes, but she didn't know what she was doing at the time. I mean, she had just killed her husband. Governor, have you given any thought as to how the women might react to her when she gets out of isolation?
Yes, that is a bit of a problem. I've given orders that she be watched very carefully, of course.
Thank you. I mean, well, apparently the women heard about what she did on the television. Do we have a single cell for her?
Yes. In fact, I've already allocated her one.
Good.
I just wish I could be more sure of her mental state. It's understandable, I know, but she's very down and I'm worried about the suicide warning.
Well, perhaps I could have a word with her, sound her out.
No, I don't think that'd be a good idea.
Well, I might be able to calm her down. After all, she does know me.
Oh, that's my point. She could blame you for what happened to you. She might even try to attack you again.
Oh, I don't think so.
Just the same, I won't take the risk. I want you to keep away from her while she's in isolation.
But surely it won't hurt.
I'm sorry, Joan, but that's an order.
Oh, you're lonesome.
That's right, Jude's taken Litza home.
Sent her packing, did you? What happened? Didn't she agree with you or something?
She wanted to go home.
Yeah? Funny, I thought she was having a real good time here. Maybe too good, huh?
And what's that supposed to mean?
Had the hots for your spunky bloke, didn't she?
Of course not.
Well, sorry, other way round was it? He had the hots for her.
Oh, don't be so ridiculous. He was just being friendly. I didn't mind him taking her out.
Hey, just in time, Jen. We was going to celebrate.
Was it?
Mickey just got little Miss Goody Two-Shoes away from her boyfriend. And I thought they were such good mates, too.
Why don't you find something constructive to do?
Touchy, aren't we? What do you reckon, Jen?
Sounds a good enough reason for a party.
Oh, Jen, you know you're not supposed to bring that stuff in here.
Too late. It's already in. So you might as well make the most of it, don't you reckon? Ripper!
All right, you can have that one, but I'm taking the rest away.
Leave it! Get your paws off me, booze.
I said I'll put the rest away. You know the rules.
Nobody touches me, booze.
You're so stupid, Jen. You've got no right to have it in here.
Nobody.
Francis, talk to your friend, will you?
I'm not going to spoil the party.
For God's sake, Jen, you're going to hurt someone. Please, just put it down on the table.
Shouldn't have touched me, booze, you bitch!
I haven't seen that other librarian around. You know, the one that usually works here?
No, in fact, you won't be seeing her for some time.
Oh, is she sick?
Nothing so simple for our Miss Gardner. She's eloped. Would you believe that? Eloped. She phoned in the other morning and casually told us that she wouldn't be here for some while.
Oh, I think we're talking about a different person. I'm talking about the girl with the sort of fluffy brown hair.
Good heavens, no. Tied in a bun. Very conservative. That's why we were so surprised. I mean, she's taken time off in the past. But eloping? Well, I mean to say, it's not like Laura at all.